The two most common network diagram technique, that is the activity on arrow and the activity on node, usually shows a graphical association between the different tasks and is used to determine the critical path. Illustrating these activities by either using node or even the arrows are the two most common ways you can draw those relationship between the different activities. So in this video, we're going to understand the difference between activity on arrow and the activity on node with the help of some examples. So without wasting any further time, let's start our today's video. So if you're watching this video for the first time on my YouTube channel, then please make sure that you hit that subscribe button and please press that bell icon so that you are notified whenever I post a new video on my YouTube channel. So in this channel, I post videos related to Six Sigma, Lean Manufacturing, Project Management and Business Management. Let us understand the activity on arrow and activity on node. So we'll start with activity on arrow. So activity on arrow, it uses an arrow to represent the activity while the node stands for an event. Like here, an activity A with duration of 5. Is represented on an arrow, while the node represents the start of activity A and the finish of activity A. Then each node represents the three numerical values. One is the start time, which is the time when the activity can actually start. Finish time, time when the activity actually finish, and the float. It basically tells you how much extra time you have or the amount of time a task can be delayed without resulting in the overall delay in the completion of any task or a project. In short, it is the excess time and the resources available to complete a task. Another name for float is slack. All this is done to figure out which activities are on my critical path. So critical path is nothing but the longest path in terms of time from start to finish. It indicates the minimum time necessary to complete the entire project. And the float on the critical path is zero. So this is how we typically represent our activity on arrow, which is quite similar to the Gantt chart. Sometimes the dummy activities have to be added to show more of this complex relationship and the dependencies between the activities. A dummy activity is represented by a dotted line in a network diagram and has no duration to it. Now let us see what is activity on node. So activity on node is represented by an arrow with nodes at each end to represent the start and the finish of an activity. They are more flexible and can show all major types of relationship. Since the activity is on node, the emphasis usually can be placed on the activity. This is how we typically represent the activity on node, where the first node is always the start event and the last node is always the end event. Both activity on arrow and activity on node comes under the program evaluation review technique, that is PERT, and the choice between these two representation is largely a matter of personal preference. The main difference between these two is that AOA diagram, that is activity on arrow, emphasizes more on the milestones or events, while the activity on node emphasizes more on the task. So before we move ahead, don't forget to share this video with all your friends and colleagues. And if you have any specific suggestions or comment, do let me know in that comment section below. Let us do a quick comparison between the activity on arrow and the activity on node with the help of some examples. So the first example is that activity A comes before activity B, which comes before activity C. That means for activity C to begin, activity B should be completed, and for activity B to start, activity A should be completed. So activity A and B must be completed before activity C can start. That means activity C is dependent upon both activity A and activity B. So both has to be completed before activity C can actually start. Another case could be both activity B and C cannot begin until the activity A is completed. That means both activity B and C are dependent upon activity A. Let's take few more cases here. So in this case, activity C and D cannot begin until the activity A and activity B both have been completed. The second case could be the activity C cannot begin until both activity A and activity B are completed, and activity D cannot begin until the activity B is completed. So here what we are doing, we are introducing a dummy activity here in the activity on arrow. Another case could be B and C activity cannot begin until the activity A is completed, and activity D cannot begin until the both activity B and C are completed. Again, we are actually introducing a dummy activity here in this case in the activity on arrow. So these are some typical examples explaining the difference between activity on node and activity on arrow representation. Now, out of these two methodologies, activity on arrow and activity on node, which one to prefer? Let's see. So activity on arrow network were more popular in 1960s and 1970s. While the activity on node focuses more on the task, activity on arrow focuses more on the events. Activity on arrow node diagrams are generally more easier to create as compared to activity on arrow diagrams. They are also generally easier to understand as compared to activity on arrow diagrams. Activity on arrow show only finish to start relationship, while activity on node can show all types of relationship, whether it is finish to start, finish to finish, start to start, and start to finish. And activity on node is widely used networking diagram and technique which is supported by most of the project management softwares. Now, choosing one over the another is based on the individual project requirement, but the above point will help you decide which method to choose and which method is more applicable to you. So if you are still watching this video, please make sure you hit that subscribe button and do press that bell icon as well. And you can also watch my other videos as well. But before that, please don't forget to hit that like button as well.